Shout out street politicians, man. Burn one, bitch. I got a new album coming. It's called, we started working on a project called Three Decades of Game. That's 30 years or too short in your life. And in the midst of it, I came across Zaytoven. I went looking for Zaytoven. My man, Mr. Fab right here, said, let's go get Zay. We need Zay. So we go get Zay, and Zay gives me like 15 beats. We go back in the lab, and we start knocking them out. And then we just knocking out one Zay beat after the other, and that shit just started sounding hot. So I was like, man, this shit is getting real pimpish. And I'm like, Three Decades of Game is what I've been doing, but we actually sat up in there off them Zay beats and we renamed the album The Pimp Tape, because that's what it motherfucking sounds like. And my man Fab right here, you could thank him, because I swear to God, I wasn't trying to make another fucking album. I was going to do some shit with E-40, do some songs with my artists, hit a verse here and there, little video, guest appearance, do some shows, but I wasn't thinking about making no fucking album. And Fab was like, nigga, fuck that. He started doing the math on me. Nigga, you about to make your 20th album, nigga. You been in the game 30 years, nigga. You better step up on these niggas and say something. Let these niggas know who the fuck Short Dog is, nigga. Quit kicking back, trying to be humble, man. Do something. That's Fab talking. What you want to tell him, man? You did say that shit.
You just got to check out the project, man. It's crazy because to the original Short Dog fan, man, who was sneaking listening to the Short albums, it's that short on there. To the new guys out there that love the Zaytoven trans beats and just want to vibe out and talk some shit, it's that short on there. And for everybody out there who was raised off of Too Short tape, the game is there. And imagine the game and his perspective nowadays. So for us to be able to put this together with Zaytoven and him, you know, Zay originally being from the Bay Area, Short being from out, you know, from all around the world, that's for sure. The earth is his turf, man. Man, we doing everything, man. If it's funky, pun intended, if it's funky, man, come on, man. We did that Beautiful Girls.
Yeah. I think after working with producers like DJ Destructo and actually getting in front of a festival crowd at an EDM festival and grabbing that energy from the crowd, and you know, even though it's an EDM day and I'm, you know, in their world, I still throw in a song like Blow the Whistle and the crowd go crazy. So I'm just like, it ain't too far apart, the worlds of electronic music, house music, whatever you want to call it. I mean, shit, I know the history of this shit. The shit came up out of Chicago, some college niggas and some hood niggas in there just dancing to house music. This shit went around the world. So I feel like if anybody's in a frame of mind going, well, trying to relate EDM as being non-urban, then you got it all fucked up, because it's like, I think that's the hottest shit in the world. The EDM up-tempo and the EDM trap and all this shit, all the different spin-off shits on this shit. When you get to that crowd, I go watch shows. I go out in the crowd and watch the shit. And it just, the way the beat transitions and shit, man, it's lovely. It's the same thing with fucking hip-hop. You get in there with some hip-hop shit right now, old school, whatever, and the motherfucker flowing. Then they get to the hood. Then they get to the crowd participation. And the fucking audience is just having a damn good time. So, you know, I'm in it, man. I'm in it all the way. I need them beats too funky. Send us some EDM trap, man.
You know, all the booster heads out there, just keep supporting me. You know, we've been doing this. Me and my fans been together for over 15 years, so, you know.
Coalition, anything Funky got to do with it, I already know it's authentic and it's genuine.
My man Funky right here is one of the serious ones. Y'all know how he represent, y'all know how he get down. He always was a man of his word, and he had the streets on lock, family from these strip clubs, so listen.